Hi, Matthew Woodward here, and welcome to my Content Machine review. We'll be going hands-on with the product, but before we jump into that, I wanted to explain a few of the key features of Content Machine and why it's so handy. It's capable of generating thousands of relevant unique titles, articles, descriptions, and tags at the click of a button. It also has a variety of advanced spinning options and can automatically spin in images, videos, and contextual links. But one of the features I like the most is the ability to export all of the generated content in any format you want, so you can import it directly into other software for submission. I've never really found an efficient and easy way to generate large volumes of unique content. I used to use GetArticle Pro until a developer abandoned it, which helped, but was still a clunky, drawn-out process. I've only been using Content Machine for a couple of months, but it has quickly become a key tool in my arsenal. The amount of time it saves is unreal. In fact, just before we jump into the software, I want to show you an example of the content it outputs. Here you can see an article that's been completely generated with Content Machine and imported into SENewKex. You can see there's an image there, some content, a video, a contextual link, we've got a word count of 597 words, and if we just spin it again, you can see it looks completely different. Title, the link's moved, the video and the image have moved around. The word counts increased to 721 words. So I just wanted to show you a few examples of the output it produces, and now I'm going to take you through step by step and show you how quickly it really is to generate all of this kind of content. So this is what Content Machine looks like. It might look a bit confusing on first glance, but I'm going to take you through everything so you understand what everything does. First thing that you'd want to do is open up the scraper options. And in here there's a number of options. You can use proxies when scraping the content if you want. I generally don't do that unless I'm doing lots of campaigns and my IP address is getting blocked, but just for the one-off campaign here and there, you don't need to use proxies. When there's not enough content, I always select to scrape for the broad match of the keyword, as it by default it goes out and searches by the phrase match, so I select that. It can also integrate with a number of spinning APIs. Personally, I use the Best Spinner, the Better Thesaurus with a word amount of 4, but it also supports the Spinner Chief API, and it's got its own built-in spinner if you haven't got access to Spinner Chief or the Best Spinner, and that has a few different options down here, but I like to use the Best Spinner. And over here, this is just where you paste in your list of proxies and set your proxy settings, but I'm not going to set those up. So let's just close out of here. And the best way to show it off really is just to set up a campaign and show you how it all fits together. So up here you can choose how many different keywords you're targeting. In this example, I'm just going to use one, and then we come down here to name our campaign. Let's assume that we're working in the payday loan niche, so our campaign name would be payday loan, and our main keyword would be payday loan. If up here we selected additional keywords, we can enter them in here, so we might have cash advance loan, for example, but just for showing you how everything works, I'm only going to use the terms payday loan. You also have options here to add contextual links into the content that it generates, but you can actually add these at a later stage. So once I've generated the content, I'll come back and show you how the contextual links work. So this is all you need to set up to generate all of the unlimited amounts of content that you need for this keyword. Once you've got your keyword set up in here, all you need to do is come up here and press generate content, and it's going to ask me if I want to continue without proxies, which I do. And straight away down here you can see the software's going out and fetching content sources. Once it's done all that, it'll come back and spin it all together, and then we'll have some content that I can show you. So I'm just going to pause the video while it runs through and fetches all the content. Okay, that's finished. It's now gone out and fetched all of the content and spun it together. Now all we need to do here is add in our contextual links. Now, the more keywords you choose, the more contextual link sets that you can add. So if we'd have chosen to target two keywords here, we'd have a second option here and we could insert more than one set of contextual links. But let's show you how to do it. First of all, you need a set of related URLs, and I've used Scrapebox to come up with a list, which I'm going to paste in here. And then you need a set of related keywords, which again, I've used a Scrapebox keyword generator tool, and I'm just going to paste that into here. Then you need to tick to use one contextual link, and you can choose the link format to be in HTML, BB code, or wiki format, depending where you're going to use the articles. So in this instance, we're just going to select HTML and click Reload Content again, and I will resume the video once it's updated that. Okay, you can see that is completed. So if we just come across to the Articles tab here, you can see that it's got titles and summaries and the body there. You can see that there's character spinning going on here because that's the options I've enabled, which I'll go over in a moment. You can see the contextual links here that we asked it to insert. There's a resource box and tags and a list of categories, and also similar information for the bookmarks tab. So if we just have a quick preview of some bookmarks, it's not perfect English, but it's certainly good enough to use on your tier 2 and 3 links. I certainly wouldn't use this content for the money site or tier 1 links, but for anything below that it is absolutely perfect. And if we reload the content again here, what it actually does is go back to the original database of content it scraped and come up with a whole new unique set of bodies and titles and everything like that to use in your campaign. So I just want to go over some of the output options quickly with you, because there's quite a lot here to choose from. For your article output settings here, generally for tier 2 links I keep things on a normal spin. For tier 3 and below I'll select normal spin and character spinning, but generally you're going to want to be using normal spinning. You can have a random paragraph count in the articles it outputs. I always choose between 7 and 10, and the paragraph spacing is done with a blank line. Most programs will accept that, but if you're going to paste direct HTML in, then you've got these options as well. Bookmark output, you've got a similar option. You can normal spin or normal spin and character spin it, and you can also alter the randomization level in which it mixes the paragraphs or sentences together. Again, this one up here is similar to the bookmark randomization level, but for your articles. The sentence mixer, this option is pretty handy on tier 3 and below. Essentially, what Content Machine does is spin articles together on the paragraph level by default, but if you wanted to spin them together on the sentence level instead, you could tick this box, choose a number of sentences per paragraph at random, and also the randomization level as well. So for your tier 2 links, untick that. Tier 3, tick that. Additional categories that you can include in the output. By default, it covers some of the more general categories that are used. You can change these though. And you can also include YouTube videos or images into the output at random. So if you were doing an article directory submission with this content, for example, you'd want to untick both of these. But if you were going to import it into the SE NewKek social network module, for example, you'd probably want to include images and videos in the output. And there's a number of different options here to show you where they display, and you can choose to insert them randomly and things like that. So they are the different output options. As you can see, that's pretty powerful. There's all sorts of different things that you can do with this. So let me take you through how we export some of this content, and then we will import it into various programs, and I'll show you how quick it really all is. So to export the content, if we just come up to the export button here, this opens the article files builder. Now, it comes supplied with some pre-made templates for SE Nuke, Article Marketing Robot, Six Submitter, and GSA Search Engine Ranker, and you can also add your own custom templates like I have here for Link Wheel Bandit, and I'll show you how to make the custom templates later on. They're really easy to do. So first of all, we're going to export an article to use in our SE Nuke campaign, and we're going to select the SE Nuke Spintax articles pre-made here and set up our export options. Now, for our SE Nuke campaign, I'm going to be using the social network module. So here I'm going to select normal spin. We're going to have a random paragraph count between 7 and 10, and blank line spacing. The bookmark output we won't be using. Paragraph mixer, I'm going to keep that at the highest randomization level, and we're not going to be mixing it on the sentence level, just on the paragraph level. additional categories, I'm going to leave it default, and I'm going to choose to include YouTube videos are center aligned. I'm going to auto resize them by width of about 400 pixels so that when they're submitted, they fit within the main body of the website we're submitting them into. And we're going to insert them into a random paragraph. We're also going to include images in the output, and they are going to be center aligned again by width of 400, and we're going to insert them into a random paragraph. So that is our SE Nuke output option set up. If we click on apply, and down here we've got a few different options for the naming. I'm just going to name it after the main keyword plus a random number and not without the link format. So this is just the file naming and how that works. And you can choose to create quite a lot of articles. In this example, I'm just going to create 25. So if we just click on export, it will go out and export all of that. I'm just going to pause the video while it does that, and I'll be back in a moment. So all of the articles have now been saved. If we click on OK, Kontent Machine will open up a window with all of our articles inside it. And you can see there it's outputted 25 articles that are ready to be imported into SE Nuke X. So I'm just going to hit new folder here, call it SE Nuke X, and copy those into there. And then we're going to generate some articles for SIG Submitter, and we'll do one for GSA as well. So for SIG Submitter articles, and we're going to change export options again. Now, because this is going to be submitted to an article directory, we do not want to include videos or images in the body, and we want to leave these outputs the same as we did for the SE Nuke output. So if we just click on apply here, and how many files we want to create, I'm just going to create the one and click on export, and it's going to ask me where to save that. So I'm just going to drop it in this payday loan folder, create a new folder here called SIG Submitter, and just call it article 1 and save. And that will export the article for us straight away. So we can just click OK on there, and that opens up there. And I'm just going to do one more output for GSA search engine ranker. So select the GSA template, change export options. I'm going to leave these at the same settings as we did for the SIG Submitter output. I'm not going to include videos or images, so we can just hit apply, and we're going to create one file, hit export. It's going to ask us where to save that, and let's just create a folder for it there, and we'll call that GSA import and hit save, and that should be completed in a moment. Okay, so let's take a look at how we import these articles into the various software. Importing the articles into SE Nuke X is easy if we just create a new social network project and open that up quickly, and then come across to the Load Articles tab and tick to load articles sequentially from the directory. And what this does is, if you remember, we outputted 25 articles in Kontent Machine for SE Nuke X, and it will randomly pick one of those each time it submits to a site. So if we tick that box and then browse to the folder that we saved the articles in, which is hidden away down here, and we can see our articles there. Now, if we come to the Preview Sample Articles tab, you can see here that we've got a title and the article body, the contextual link, a video, an image, and some more content there with a total word count of 687. If we just spin that again, you can see the contextual links moved. We've got an image here in a different place, and this time the video's closer to the end of the article and a word count of 590. And just once more, again, everything's moved around at random. So you can see how powerful Kontent Machine is to output huge batches of content, and you can just import it in a couple of clicks into SE Nuke X and go out and submit it to all of these sites. So let's now show you how easy it is to import the content into SIG Submitter. I'll be back in a moment once I've got that open. In SixSubmitter, let's assume that you've filled out all of your account information and everything like that, and you wanted to submit some articles. You can just come to the Article Creator tab here, click the Open button, and we can browse to our SixSubmitter export, which is here, and open that up. It'll take a little second just to load it because there's so much content. And you can see here it's filled everything out. I know the title looks blank, but I'll show you that it's not in a minute. We've got the summary there, the body, resource box, keywords, and of course all of the categories all ready to go. So if we just click on preview here, you can see that the title actually is there, and we can just spin through that, and you can see that all the articles are very unique. The body word count is constantly changing up and down, and it's really that easy to import into SixSubmitter. So let's just look at how quickly we can set up a GSA campaign with Content Machine. And in GSA Search Engine Ranker, all we need to do is come across and create a new campaign. And we can tick all of these different types here. And then down here, we can go to Tools, Import, Data Fields, and come into our GSA export here and click on Open. And as you can see, that's filled out most of the fields for us. There's only a few left to fill out, like category and email address and things like that. And if we just test that here, you can see the content already all filled out. So it's really good for setting up GSA campaigns. In fact, you can set up a full GSA campaign in less than 3 or 4 minutes with Content Machine, and actually the two working together is just a really nice combination. So that's how easy it is to set up a GSA campaign. I think that took about 30 seconds. Just need to add your URLs and emails and set your options, and that's it. It's done. It really is that easy. And the last part of Content Machine I wanted to show you was the custom export options and how to set that up. Let me show you how I've set up the one for Link Wheel Bandit, and you'll get a good idea of how this works. So if I open that up. Now, Link Wheel Bandit will import articles in TXT format from a directory, and the articles must have the title as the first line, and then everything else underneath that becomes a body that gets submitted to all the Web2 sites in Link Wheel Bandit. So as you can see here, the first line is a nested spun title. In fact, let's just clear it out and I'll build it along with you. So the first line here is a nested spun title. Then we have a nested summary. And then we can have a nested article body. And finally, a nested resource. And as you can see here, you've got different options. So if you were importing into a program that had the title as a first line, or a bookmarking program with the title as a first line, you could say, well, I'll have a nested title as a first line, and then a nested bookmark body as a second line, and it might import the tags from the last line or something like that. So you could say import the tags from the last line. So any piece of software that allows you to import articles, you can create a template to export to in Content Machine really easily. And this has to be one of the most powerful parts of the whole software, because it makes it work with pretty much every link building product that's out there that you can import articles into. So that's the power of it. I just want to show you how flexible it was there. There are a couple of other tools here that you can use. I never really use them though. I just keep to this campaign tab and exporting the articles to import into other tools. But there are a couple of other little tools here that you can use. So that brings me to the end of my Content Machine review. As you can see, it's a really flexible tool that allows you to produce huge amounts of unique content at the click of a button. The most powerful feature is the ability to export all of that content in any format for use in other programs. As you've seen, it makes it really quick and painless to set up link campaigns and will save you huge amounts of time. In all honesty, it's one of the few pieces of software that's worth every penny. The benefits it offers are unrivaled when it comes to the amount of time and effort it saves you. It really is an essential piece of software for any SEO, period.